actually, we're expecting Kiss. And who are you guys?
We are the Clark Kent to that system.
Terrific, terrific.
There is a real power in the black and white makeup, right? I've heard you refer to it as sacred.
It is, it is. I mean, it's been 50 years now. You know, it's amazing to think that first time we came here was 1980, and we experienced Kisteria.
Kisteria.
Yeah, and, you know, to have something that's been that timely, it kind of eclipses us as mere mortals.
And it can actually change any mere mortal into a rock god, can't it, the makeup? We've got a bit of a bit of a list of photos here. Look at that. Look, Meryl, like, what a rocker there. Taylor.
But that's actually not far from reality. Taylor and the whole band came out in Kiss makeup, and you can go on YouTube and Schmootube and see it.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Look at this. As a matter of fact, that was the makeup she chose.
That's amazing. Right.
I know that guy.
What about this guy?
What about this guy?
There he is.
Good looking.
Yeah, that's what
I guess I'm just saying is, like, when you guys finally retire, do you mind if I just step in? The show goes on?
Did we both do that at the same time?
You're in sync.
No, we're not. That's another band.
That's not bad. I'll remember that forever. Now, you guys are in Australia. You got the grand final this weekend. You got your final ever show in Sydney. I thought last time was the final time. Can we believe you?
It's actually true. You know, when we were here last, we really felt that that was it, and it was teary-eyed, and we said goodbye. But we were asked to come back, and we're not kicking open the door. People asked us to come.
One last time.
Yeah, and we've had such an amazing relationship with everybody here. This country, God bless you. You don't even know how wonderful you have it here. This is an incredible country, and any chance we could get to come here, we would take. So we said gladly, we'll do it one more time. So we're here, but this is it, of course.
Well, you know you're allowed to stay. You could just stay here and, like, just play a show every week or two.
People joke with us, hey, why don't you come and stay for a while? I would live here. There's no question about it. I mean, the truth is that it's so far away, that's the negative. But otherwise, people are better looking, the weather's great. You know, everything is great about Australia.
Why can't you make a bad Shiraz? I mean, you don't know how. I mean, it's amazing.
I'll tell you, if you're looking for a visa, cash.
That'll do it.
Now, it's been 50 years since your very first show. How emotional are you about all about wrapping everything up?
Well, it's interesting because we can see the end now. You know, when we started to plan this was probably about 5 years ago. And the pandemic came into play, and we lost a few years. We've done 250 shows on this end of the road tour.
Wow.
Because it's a long road, and they kept paving more road. But this is it for us. And intellectually, yeah, we go, we can't continue doing this. We're in our 70s. Hard to believe.
You're kidding.
Looking good.
Boy, looking great.
You look good.
But isn't that what the makeup's for? It just allows you to be ageless.
Yeah, we're...
Well, in real life, we're not so bad.
No, I agree. Nice.
But, you know, for us, it's just reached a point where we realize we can't do this indefinitely. We're really at the top of our game still. And now's the time to do a victory lap and go out there with our heads held high and say thank you to everybody and do a show that really encapsulates and really pays tribute not only to us but to the fans.
But we can't wait, I got to tell you. We've been talking about this. Footy is not an American thing.
Footy is a
distinctly Aussie thing, proudly so. Mm. You have to be careful what you say, because if you get a Collingwood fan and you happen to say the Lions at the same time, your ass is grass.
Yeah. This is not for the pies.
Thank God. I'm glad you clarified.
See, look
that.
At that.
You know, this is a fashion statement, not a footy statement.
Right. Okay, that's good to know.
Well, we can't wait, and there are going to be lots of surprises. We're going to really ramp it up. And then, of course, the very last time we're ever going to play your beautiful country is going to be at the stadium in Sydney. Not too far from now, and we're really going to amp it up. We're going to shake the heavens, because that's what we do.
Yeah. No doubt. Yes. The grand final, though, I mean, what a gig that is. How many? You seem to have tapped into the details, who's playing and all. Have you watched much footy? Do you know much about
sure.
the sport?
As a matter of fact, I go back when we had a TV show called Gene Simmons Family Jewels that was on the air for 8 years and 167 episodes. one of our shows happened to be with the, I know they just lost out on the finals, the Carlton Blues, and...
My God, you're right across this. This wow. is
I quote, bought the team and then flipped it for a little profit.
Right. yeah.
Yeah, that. Back in the days when they weren't doing so well. Yeah. Now they're really... Yeah, I mean, they could have been in the finals.
Well, yeah. Mm. Well, the grand final, absolutely.
Grand final okay. crowds are notoriously hard to impress. Have you got anything to say to them to light them up?
Good on you.
Wow, that's... I've got goosebumps right now. Now, I wanted to test your knowledge of AFL, if that's possible, because there's a lot of terms and, you know, there's Australian colloquial language. I wanted to put you guys to the test.
Can we first start with it's ketchup, not tomato sauce?
Oh, OK.
Oh, look at that.
Now yeah, people aren't happy. But what about...
Jane, if you're going to move here, you're going to have to figure out...
It's witch's hats, not a traffic cone. I know it's fairy floss, not cotton candy. Okay, I got
okay.
it.
Okay, so I wanted to put you to the...
But I can say, how you going?
Oh, hey, how you going? You're in. That's good, not bad at all.
Good on ya.
Good on ya.
How you going?
How you going? Well, how you going? So this game I want to play with you guys is Aussie insult or footy term. These are terms. I want you to tell me whether it's an Aussie insult or a footy term. So let's start. First one, worm burner. What do you think? Which one? Footy term or an insult?
It's a footy term.
He's good.
Excellent.
He's good. He's a Carlton man. He gets it. Under the table. Okay, next one. Drongo. Footy term or insult?
No, it's an insult.
Oh, my God. This is unbelievable.
Absolutely.
Well, he's deferring to Gene and all this.
He knows what
I agree with him when he's right.
Okay.
If he's right, I agree with him. Otherwise, he's wrong.
All right, last one. Aussie insult or footy term? White maggot.
I don't know what... I don't know.
Well, you got to...
You know,
that's
you gotta,
an insult.
Well, it's kind of an insult.
Is it a footy term or not? I say it's
I think we give
term.
That to them. I think we can... They got it. They got it right there. It's a footy term and an insult. Yeah. Umpires are called white maggots.
It's because the umpires used to wear white and that's what the supporters were called.
Yeah.
Very good. All. He's all over it. Hey, don't miss your chance to kiss goodbye to Kiss with their last ever Australian show. All the details are on our website. They're, of course, playing the AFL Grand Final on Saturday as well. Would you please give it up? You know who they are. Paul Stanley and Nick Simmons! I mean, this is... They don't normally bring banners. It's quite something.